Well, howdy! Howdy, partner, and a whoop, whoop, whoop. Me, Beer Goggles Reviews, and I apologize to anyone in America. I'm doing an American beer. I'm going to see if I can squeeze that off my head. It's squeezed on my head, it's left a big ring up there. But there you go. Top of my head's red. I'm really in a good mood. I really am in a good mood. I've just got this one in from through the post from the fabulous guys down at Dominion. And all the way from the good US of A. And this is an oak barrel stout. Now, there's a lot of special things about this one. A lot of special things about this. Let me just tell you what I've got on the back here. Our method of dry hopping with vanilla beans and oak chips broadens the stout's flavour spectrum. Flavour with a, with just an O. Look, you spelt it wrong, guys. Look, I know. Tease. There is it. Flavour. Look, look. You're going to have to get this right, boys. I've lost it. I can't read back to front. I can't even read anyway. But it's O-U-R. Flavour. Where are we? Broadens the flavour spectrum even further. Now, I love a stout. I love oak aged stuff. Now, I believe it doesn't say on here, but I'm sure I read somewhere else that we're talking peat smoked malts. Now, I've had them a couple of times in different beers, and it's always a dangerous thing, the peat smoked stuff. Sorry, I'm right on top of you there, I was. Always a dangerous thing. You either get it right or you get it wrong. Now, I'm hoping that we get it right because it just sounds so gorgeous. If you get it wrong, it tastes medicinal. It kind of tastes like that tea tree oil and things like that. Tastes antiseptic. If you get it right, it's lovely. It's bang on. Especially with stouts, it just adds a beautiful, beautiful flavour. So, let's crack this... this gorgeous little bottle. Ooh. Bottle open, and there's a. You got that? A lovely, lovely stag there. Beautiful, beautiful thing. I love some of these kind of slightly understated bottles. Now, that's beautiful. Can you hear our English weather here? Rain everywhere. Let's pour that in and see how we go. Ooh. Don't know if I'm going to get the whole lot in me. Whoa! Not quite the whole lot. I've got a tiny little bit left. Because this is a 355, I believe. It is a 355 milliliter. Millimeter? So there's a lovely head on it. And that beautiful head. Look at that. Just beautiful. You know from those bubbles, when you get kind of all those different sizes and shapes of bubbles, you know it's not got none of that E405 in that kind of gluey rubbish, that wallpaper paste that some brewers seem to be putting in the beers now. You know it's not got none of that in. You know, it's not a meringue head. It's dissipating beautifully. But it's holding on, so it's got plenty of proteins in there. I would imagine there's a little bit of wheat in there or oat or something. Yeah, so that's beautiful. That really is. Right, let's have a sniff. Let's have a sniff of the neck. I think they're going to have this right because there's a tiny background of peat in there somewhere. I'm not getting massive amounts on the bugle. Yeah, it's not getting much up the old hooter. I'm back in on yous again. I'm not close like this. I do that when I get excited. Start leaning forward. Hey. Right, let's have a little, I think I might have a little taste. Getting slight, kind of almost burnt toast notes, but kind of well done toast as well. You're getting almost a buttery note in there. Perhaps from the vanilla. Oh yeah, you get... You're getting back notes of that vanilla as well. Let's dive in. Cheers, guys. Cheers. Guys and girls, I should say. It's a bit misogynistic. Look at that. Alster. Alstones out there. Oh. You want that happening in the background when you're having a nice, beautiful... That is beautiful. You're getting... That vanilla goes beautiful with those oaky sort of taste that you're getting. Yeah, you're getting oaky notes. You're getting... kind of, it's like when you get sometimes... Dark. When you get sometimes you get certain whiskey aged drinks when they're kind of peat whiskey, when they're kind of peat barrels and that. You're getting a little bit of that in there, but it's really done subtly and beautifully. Oh, it's clean. So many stouts are just like too cloying and sticky and that. This is clean. It's both refreshing and warming at the same time. It doesn't seem to be 5.8 ABV. It seems slightly lower. But that's nice. Fermented with vanilla beans. Vanilla pods, I believe, is what I mean. Look at that. I've just thrown the bottom end of that in. And that's popped up again. That is beautiful. Just see how those stretch. How those kind of proteins stretch out there. Hang on and hang on and stretch out. And they kind of almost look like a bubble inside the glass. Beautiful. Lovely. Thick proteins. You're getting a tiny little background bounce of like a tangerine skin, you know, tangerine peel, just zesting the background up. That's really lovely. And it's just in there, kind of just enough to balance in with those malts and go, oh, by the way, zing, zing, zing. You know, instead of it being, it lightens the load and pumps it up. That is lovely. Do you know what? It's almost gone. Well, that is beautiful. Guys, girls, buy it and try it. Buy it. But as my girl says, buy it, try it, like it. That is gorgeous. Cheers, guys. Cheers, girls. Chin, chin, bottoms up. Cheers. Oh, and howdy!